We must say what we think. We must do what we say. We must also be what we do. Although spokesman of the management board of Deutsche Bank for only a few years, Alfred Herrhausen was an outstanding businessman who made a lasting impression on the public during his life. Born in Essen in 1930, the son of a surveyor, he attended an elite National Socialist school in Upper Bavaria until 1945. When the war ended, he continued his schooling in his hometown. He had initially wanted to study philosophy, but ultimately studied for a degree in business administration and obtained his doctorate in 1955. While at university, he worked as an executive assistant to the management of Ruhrgas AG in Essen. His next career move also took him into industry when he joined the head office of Vereinigte Elektrizitätswerk Westfalen AG, VEW. During this time, he gained initial experience in banking while working as a loan administrator and financial analyst in New York. He continued to rise up the ranks of VEW and in 1967 he joined the management board. He was particularly interested in all aspects of modern business management. In 1970, Herrhausen made the move from industry to banking and joined the management board of Deutsche Bank. In the rather staid ranks of the management board, Herrhausen, the newcomer to the sector with his youthful air, was given responsibility for international business in North and South America, Australia, New Zealand and South Africa, as well as for foreign trade finance at the bank and economic issues. He also was responsible for the branch business in his hometown, Essen. In 1971, overcoming some resistance from a few of his colleagues, he obtained approval from Franz Heinrich Ulrich, spokesman of the management board, to develop a strategic planning system in Deutsche Bank. As a member of the management board of Deutsche Bank, over time he became the natural choice for an increasing number of seats on supervisory boards, the most important of which was undoubtedly the post as chairman of the supervisory board of Daimler-Benz during the period known as the Deutschland AG era. Alfred Herrhausen played a key role at the interface of politics and business. For example, as a member of the working group Banking Structure Commission. He was one of the forces behind the Ruhr Initiative Group and a co-founder of the Action Committee for Europe, an association of influential European industrialists who supported the European integration process. He was also one of the directors of Germany's first private university in Wittenherdecke. Herrhausen was friends with German Chancellor Helmut Kohl. In 1985, Alfred Herrhausen was chosen to succeed Wilfried Gut as one of the two spokesmen of the management board of Deutsche Bank. He held the office jointly with F. Wilhelm Christians in the dual leadership which was standard at the bank at the time. He became sole spokesman on May the 11th, 1988. Power is something you also have to want, was one of Herrhausen's frequently quoted aphorisms. He also saw his leading role in the world of business as an opportunity to assume responsibility in the community. During his years in office, he raised many social and ecological issues. In light of the worsening third world debt problems, Herrhausen was the first representative of a big bank to support a program of debt release linked to economic reforms. His strong presence in the media gave him a high level of public visibility, unusual for a bank manager at the time.
Das Problem kann nur gelöst werden durch eine vernünftige Wirtschaftspolitik. Und die muss dort angewendet werden, wo wir die Probleme vorfinden, vor Ort, in den Entwicklungsländern. Und deswegen ist ein solcher disziplinierender Effekt, der die Länder veranlasst, wirklich eine vernünftige Wirtschaftspolitik zu betreiben, nicht nur gewollt, er ist notwendig und wie ich meine auch im Interesse der gesamten Weltwirtschaft willkommen.
Unlike some of his contemporaries, Herrhausen recognized the fall of the Berlin Wall from the outset as the precursor of the unification of East and West Germany. 3 weeks later, on November the 30th, 1989, Alfred Herrhausen fell victim to a terrorist attack on the way to his office. The crime has never been solved. The Alfred Herrhausen Society, the International Forum of Deutsche Bank, established by Deutsche Bank in 1992, bears his name.